Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The people often ask me, which ayah of yours is the favorite ayah? And for me personally, it is Ayatul Kursi. The reason for this is because it is as though we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are you? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. Allah, He is the one who is ever living, al-hayy, al-qayyum, the one who exists on His own, and He requires nothing in existence to exist. And He is the one by whom everything exists, and they cannot exist without Him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes Himself to us in this ayah. When Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu anhu was asked by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَيُّ آيَةٍ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ أَعْظَمٍ, which ayah is the greatest ayah in the Quran, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu anhu says, Ayatul Kursi. It is Ayatul Kursi. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hit him on his chest, or you could say he touched him on his chest, and he says, لِيَهْنِكَ الْعِلْمُ يَا أَبَا الْمُنذِرِ, that ilm and knowledge is a good thing for you, O Aba al-Munzir. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam acknowledged that this ayah is the greatest ayah in the Quran. And the reason for this is because if we take a look at the subject matter of this ayah, then it is none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The greatest surah in the Quran is Ummul Kitab, Fatihatul Kitab, the Fatiha that we recite every day in our salah. The reason for it being, the best surah in the Quran is because again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about Himself. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدْ. This surah is known as a third of the Quran. It actually counts for a third of the Quran. Why? Because again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing Himself and His qualities. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. But if we were to stop at Allah, we would be able to continue without the meaning being changed from la ta'khudhuhu sinatun wa la nawm. So we would say, Allah la ta'khudhuhu sinatun wa la nawm. Allah, the one who sleepiness, does drowsiness does not overtake Him. Wa la nawm, nor does sleep overtake Him. You find that a human being goes to sleep at times. In fact, every day a human being will go to sleep. Whilst he is asleep, he is not able to address the concerns of his family. He is not able to address the concerns of the fellow human beings. But when he is awake, then he can do this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not sleep. So people ask Him at all times, people need Him at all times, and He is there providing for them, sustaining them, responding to their dua. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not sleep. And as a result, He is the one who we should seek protection in. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Perhaps you will one day have a problem at home. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Perhaps a burglar comes into your house and you begin to shout out, oh my father, oh my father. But he is sleeping. He cannot help you. Yet Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, when you call out to Him, He never sleeps. So He will be there ready to protect you. He will be there ready to help you. Ya Allah, help me. And if you say it, muqinan fil qalbi, really and truly believing it in your heart, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal will most definitely help you. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. To Him belongs everything in the heavens and everything on earth. So if a person is having difficulty with his neighbor, having difficulty perhaps with his business partner, or he is fearing some magic that was done on him from someone, then let him know that that being, that person that has harmed him, belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why not seek refuge in the owner of that person? Do you not think he will protect you? Do you not think he has the capacity to change the affairs completely? And it is very important for us to mention here that let us not go into the completely haram manner of doing this. Some people you will find, they will go to a witch doctor who will tell them, you know, you need to take the bones, do this, do that, and then if you do this ritual, then you will get rid of this. Perhaps that may completely get rid of the problem that you have, but it will put you into another problem, and that is you have taken shaitan as a guardian besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So trust in the one who created those beings to protect you. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ. Who is it that will make shafa'ah, intercession with him, except by his permission? رَبُّ الْعِزَّةِ وَالْجَلَالِ. On the day of Qiyamah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he himself will need the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make that shafa'ah. He will put his head on the ground and he will be doing sajda for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And only when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him to raise his head, will he raise his head. Irfa' ra'saka ya Muhammad. Raise your head, O Muhammad. And then he will tell him, sal tu'ta washfa' tushaffa'. Say, he will say, ask and you will be given, and do the shafa'ah and you will be given the shafa'ah that you so desperately seek from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if this is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man dha alladhi yashfa'u indahu illa bi'idhni. Who is it that will be able to give that shafa'ah except by his permission? Ya'lamu ma bayna aydihim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that which is in front of them. Wa ma khalfahum. And that which is behind them. يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. And they have absolutely no knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except that which He has given them. يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ. Which means that He knows whatever happened in your life. You've been through difficulty, you've been through hardship, you've been through problems. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it. And since He is the one who created you, He will take care of it. وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ. And that which is in front of them as well. Whatever they are going to face in the future, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of it. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. So He knows everything, yet the creation knows very little of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to them. وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. His kursi has encompassed the entire heavens and the earth. So imagine how great رَبُّ الْعِزَّةِ وَالْجَلَالِ is, if this is just the kursi. And this is why this ayah is known as Ayatul Kursi, because a person understands the azamah, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. And the protection of this heaven and the earth, it does not tire Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any way whatsoever. And He is the Most High, Al-Azim, the Great. So as we can see, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes so much of Himself. Perhaps in a longer session, we would be able to explain in true detail who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from this ayah. Obviously, we will never be able to encompass the sifat and the asma of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we can only have a glimpse into that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the manner that He wants us to worship Him, and bearing in mind His greatness. Ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم.